good sign.
Great.
Well, my name is Jisung Kim. I'm from South Korea.
My name's Emma.
And I was born in Seoul. Seoul is a very huge city.
How many people are in your family?
Eight.
I have one brother and three sisters, but they're all married now, so we have a huge family. I have eight nephews. There's like 16 of us.
I have a brother who's 2 years younger than I am.
It gets super crazy. It's a lot of fun. I love it. The craziness just feeds the fire, which is a good fire.
Emma, what's a Christmas tradition that your family has?
We all clean the house Christmas morning before we can open presents.
Sounds awful.
So, every year as a family, we'd read Christmas Oranges, or we'd read about Christ's birth, which was really cool.
Toys, family and toys, also snow.
Christmas Eve is my birthday, so I just focus on my birthday.
Probably one of my favorite parts of Christmas is we all get matching pajamas on Christmas Eve. And sometimes we eat like full pajamas, all of us, even the old people.
Onesies?
Onesies, that's what they're called. Sometimes we get onesies and it's legit.
And my sister would always open up her presents. She would always go downstairs at like 2 in the morning and open them up every single year. And nobody knew. She told us like a year ago.
What's another Christmas tradition that you and your family had?
So we have like this calendar thing. It's Mary and she's like sitting on a donkey and we like move it each day. And then on the 25th day, she's at the manger. And it was always exciting to be able to like move it because you're getting closer to Christmas.
So my Christmas traditions, we get together with my family and we have a big old Christmas party. We eat lots of delicious food. We do a talent show and my little cousins participate.
In my country, in South Korea, we celebrate Christmas. Just like have fun, and many couples they get together, and it's not a really huge family thing. Friends hang out, we celebrate, and we have fun, and we do a lot of shopping and spend a lot of money and time with the friends.
So every Christmas Eve, yeah. We'd always go to a movie as a family. Like, we didn't go out to the movies ever as a family, but every Christmas Eve we'd go to the movies. We'd go see a movie and get a nice dinner and get pajamas and then a lot of the time watch another movie at home, which was great.
Nice. What's the best present you've ever gotten on Christmas?
Best present? Mm-hmm. Legos. Every time.
Favorite Christmas present?
One time I got a Barbie carriage.
One time I got a Spider-Man video game. I convinced my dad, hey, we need to make sure if this works, right? And Christmas that year was on a Sunday. So I just said, well, Dad, I better play this video game just to make sure that it works, or else like that would be a bummer. And he was like, okay. I tricked my dad into making me play video games on Sunday.
I got Batman 1 year. We all got Batman stuff. It was legit.
Batman pajamas?
Yeah. My mom knew what was up.
Better, better, better present.
The red plastic Jeep that I would try and ram into the neighbor's kids. And chase them around and hit them with guns.
Favorite Lego set.
Favorite Lego set? That's hard.
It's like picking a favorite child.
No, let's be real, you have your favorite children. You just, Lego sets, there's a lot more. There's a Star Wars one with all these blue soldiers in it. It's got a big turd in it. That's my favorite. I've gotten them like 4 times, so I've gotten an army of blue soldiers. So life is good. It's
cool. That was the best Christmas present you ever got. And don't you dare mention your scripture markers.
What would it be? One time for Christmas, I got one of those electric razors. Those were fun. I love those. It has the throttle, so it's almost like a motorcycle. So when you get on it, it kind of goes. And I remember trying it, falling off because I went too fast at the beginning and just kind of I would get on that and ride around the cul-de-sac, and that was my highlight of the whole year. So I love that so much.
This is really funny. Something that my dad would do is we would just walk around the mall, and he would say, "Imagine you have $100 and spend it on whatever you want, and we'll buy it, and we'll wrap it up, and we'll put it under the tree, and on Christmas you can open it." That's how my dad rolled.
We never got to eat sugar cereal, and so she would wrap sugar cereal, and then each Christmas, only on Christmas, we'd have like sugar cereal and candy for breakfast.
My best Christmas presents were ones that I all picked out.
What was your favorite cereal or candy to start the day with?
I really liked those like cookie ones, like the cookie cereal, do you know?
Cookie Crisps?
Maybe, is that what it's called? With the wolf or whatever? Yeah, okay. I really liked that one, because then I was like eating cookies for breakfast.
Christmas in South Korea, it's a very simple thing. Especially Christmas Eve is my birthday. So I always think about my birthday. And then get a lot of presents and then a lot of cake and many people gave to me. They don't care about Jesus and Heavenly Father. Also, when I had a boyfriend in South Korea, I really enjoyed my birthday with him. So it was so fun.
What's the best present you've ever gotten?
For me, like, I can't actually really remember like a present like specifically. I just remember how I felt. And I guess the best thing for me for Christmas isn't presents, it's like the people. And I think the people is what makes it so memorable. And like what I remember is just like how I felt, not so much like what I got.
What were your family traditions?
We would always make gingerbread houses, but we would open up the roofs and like pack it full of candy until it was all the way full, and then we would close the roof. So that way when the Christmas candy was gone in the family, we would have our stash inside of the houses. So you just break off a roof and then we just eat them. And I'd eat off of theirs and they'd eat off of mine. We all get mad at each other. It was awesome.
How did you and your family open presents? Was it one at a time or was it go for it?
It was one at a time and my mom had a code, so none of the presents had labels. So no one could peek, because when she was growing up, she always peeked, so she just put labels so we would never know whose present was whose.
Long.
Okay. As a kid, me and my family have had many traditions. Around Christmas time, service is a really important thing for us. Whenever Christmas would get closer, usually my parents would start planning things that they would do to help their neighbors more often. Me being a little kid, usually I would complain when we had to go out and do things that I didn't like to do. When we gave toys to people that needed them, I would usually whine and say, "Why are you giving them my toys? Like, why can't I have those toys?" But they would say, "Someone else needs them." So I was kind of a little brat sometimes, but I loved going out with my family.
We do sub for Santas every now and again, where we bring tons of gifts to the families that can't, and that's been some of the best times I've had, is just being able to gather stuff. It's exciting, it's fun.
So every Christmas, my family would go and like give presents to the neighbors. I think it was the 12 days of Christmas. We'd do stuff like that. And my mom would always make a nice little basket, and then I would run up to the door and get to doorbell ditch them, which was always great because it was a good excuse to doorbell ditch someone.
One specific time we went out and gave some families some food, a big turkey and some other things and some toys. And we as a family chose the things that we wanted to give to them. I remember that leaving a big impression on me. It's one of those memories that is kind of a dream almost because I was young enough. I'll never forget that.
I'd say most memorable was Sub for Santa we did a few years back. I didn't know the family well and I hadn't met them before. I remember getting everyone together and getting all the stuff together and just how excited we all were to go and ding-dong ditch it and then run and hide. And
I feel like everyone is a lot more giving around the Christmas season. The air kind of feels like happier. I really like that. People are more willing to forgive, more willing to like give the benefit of the doubt around Christmas, which like people should always do, but you don't always see the rest of the year.
What do you want to do for this Christmas for your family or friends?
I remember one of my favorites was the Sub for Santa, so we're doing that again this year. We found a few families that we're going to take stuff to, and it's just the most exciting thing to be able to put everything together for them.
I really hope that people will understand that serving and following the example of Jesus Christ is really going to change the world. I believe that with all my heart. A savior was a real person. If this is the spirit of Christ of service, if this is what it is, me as a little kid understanding this and feeling this, I knew that it was something that I wanted throughout my life.
Christmas Eve was the time that my family all got together and we read the story of Christ. We were never allowed to open up a present early. Our dad always said, before you get to the Christmas, you've got to get to the purpose. And then we would read the story of Jesus Christ. So that was our Christmas Eve. And that's when we would make gingerbread houses.
When I came to Utah, I was able to learn the gospel. But that is a really weird thing, like a really opposite situation. So I don't have a family here, and then most of my friends, they're gonna go to their hometown or they're gonna go to their parents' house during the Christmas holidays. So I was so lonely. And I just stay home and then thinking about my birthday. Oh my gosh, my birthday is so awful in Utah. So I sometimes cry that, and then finally I recognize that, oh, I should think about what is the meaning of the Christmas in my life. And when I focus on that, I was able to know Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ too, and what is the meaning of their huge love in my life. And I was able to think about how to serve many people who celebrate my birthday. And then I realized that, oh, Heavenly Father gave me this special birthday because to remember His awesome love to everyone. So nowadays, I changed my mind and I'm thinking about how to share my testimony, how to share my warm heart to another. I don't think about my birthday too much because Heavenly Father changed my birthday meaning.
What's your favorite Christmas movie?
White Christmas.
White Christmas?
Nice.
I don't know what that is.
What?
My bad.
You don't know what White Christmas is?
Moving on.
Wait, is that recording?
What?